Hello children, hope all of you are fine. So let's see what are we going to read today. Today we'll be reading literature, class 4, lesson 7, that is your caucus race. So let's just have a look. First of all children, when we read about the caucus race, when we hear the word caucus race, what comes in our mind? Okay, it is a race in which a group of people participate, like a race. We all know there are so many kinds of race, as you can see here in the picture. Page 91, you may find this. So first one, you can see there are some boats, isn't it, in the first number. So what does that race is said as? They are said as regatta. Okay children, just put a mark there. You can put it number one, regatta. The second is the race done by horses, they are said to be as derby. Derby, D-E-R-B-Y, derby. The third one is the car race, they are said to be as rally. Rally, please mark it down in your book. The fourth one is a group of people running together, they are said to be as marathon. And the last race in which people, like it is a half part of the race, some people will run, the other next person will be running the next half of the race, and they carry a stick with them. This race is said to be as a relay race. Clear? Do it fast. Now we'll have a look. These are the races. Yes, we see the races and we have already heard about these races, the horse races, car races and the marathon, these relays. But we have never heard about the caucus race. So caucus race children, there is a mention of this race in Alice Adventures in the Wonderland. So this is a very unique play children. I hope you all have read the story or would have seen any movie or cartoons with this, Alice in the Wonderland. So in that story, everything strange happens. So let's just have a look on this story. First, let us know about the characters. Who all are the character? The first main character is Alice. So here the whole story revolves around Alice. The second character is Laurie. Laurie is a kind of a bird. Dodo? Dodo is also a kind of bird children, but it is now extinct. We generally don't find them. Mouse. Canary. Canary is also a kind of bird, small bird. And the last character is lizard. So first the narrator introduces us to all the characters and the story. Okay, so we'll get to know the story. It's a very interesting story. So let's begin. The narrator says, "Have you met Alice before? Today we are going to meet her and hear about a wonderful adventure she had in Wonderland." So the narrator is calling out Alice and he is asking Alice to say all the adventure, like all the adventures she used to face and she used to enjoy in the Wonderland. So the narrator says, "Oh, hello Alice, let us start our story at the beginning." So Alice says, "One day I was beginning to get very tired of sitting by my sister on the river bank and of having nothing to do, when suddenly a white rabbit with pink eyes ran close by me, saying to itself, 'Oh dear, oh dear, I shall be late.' I followed the rabbit down its hole and..." So children, here you will see that Alice, what all things she is doing. She is right now very tired. She is with her sister at the side of the river and she had nothing to do. And suddenly what she saw, that there was a white rabbit. The rabbit was having pink eyes and it was running close to her and he was saying he was getting late. So what Alice decided, she decided to follow the rabbit. Let's see what happened next. "I followed the rabbit down its hole, and what a fall I had. Down, down, down. I thought the fall would never come to an end. Then I found myself in a long hallway but the doors were all shut. I looked through the window and saw a beautiful garden with colorful flowers. There was a golden key on a three-legged table, but the doorway was too small for me to enter. I found a little bottle labeled "Drink Me" on the table. Since the bottle did not say poison, I took a sip. It tasted like custard and pineapple and hot buttered toast all at once. Now I was the right size to go through the door into the garden. So children, after following that rabbit, she found herself like she was standing in a hallway and all the doors were shut. So what she saw, that she could see through the windows, and out the window she found a beautiful garden. But everything was locked. So, and the doorway from where she could enter, that was also very small. So what she did, she found a little bottle. And in that bottle, it was written "Drink Me." So since it was not written poison, she took the sip. And the taste, the flavor of that thing is told to us. And after drinking that, children, she became of the right size. And now she's of the right size to go through that door. So the narrator is saying, but when she reached the door, Alice found out that it had slipped her mind to bring the golden key, and the three-legged table was now too high for her to reach. So yes, now instead of she forgot to take that key, with the help of that key only this she could just go outside. No, she forgot to take, and now she is of very small size. So let's see what happens next. Alice says,
I didn't lose heart. I looked under the three-legged table and found a lovely cake in a box. I am sure I never saw it before. It had the words "Eat Me" marked on it with black currants. I ate the cake and it made me grow and grow till my head touched the roof.
So, as she forgot bringing the key, she was a little bit upset about it, but then she did not lose her heart. She looked under the table and what she found, there was a cake. And in that cake, it was written, "Eat me." Here you will find the word black currants. Yes, children, what does black currant means? Black currant means is a kind of fruit. Okay, and with the help of that fruit, it was written, "Eat me." So she ate it. And as she ate it, she grew up in size. How much tall? She grew and she touched the roof of the building. Narrator says, so Alice began to cry and she said gallons of tears that made a large pool. Then several strange animals began to collect around her in the pool. Among them were a mouse, a lizard, a dodo, a lorry and a canary. Together they swam to the bank. They were indeed a queer looking party, all dripping wet, cross and uncomfortable. And now begins the story of the caucus race. So this is how the caucus race will begin. We'll get to know how it happened. So as she grew taller, no, now she started crying. Who started? Alice started crying. And when she cried, like so much water, there was a pool made of water around her. And everyone, like animals, gathered around that pool. Like they all were inside the pool. As the narrator speaks, Alice and others swim to the shore. Alice says,
I wish I hadn't cried so much. I nearly drowned in my own tears.
Brrr. Dodo says, we need to get dry.
How do we get dry here? I don't see towels.
I am older. I'll tell you how we can draw ourselves. So here the conversation between all the characters begins. Till now we were only aware of Alice and the narrator. Everything the narrator said and what all thing happened with Alice, the story was clear to us. But now each and every characters, as I said you earlier, Dodo, Lorry, Canary, Lizards, everyone, Mouse, everyone will be coming one by one. So here the Alice is now wishing that if she would not have cried, she would not have drowned in her own tears, and everyone is now wanting to dry themselves. Now Alice is even in a confused state that she could not see any kinds of tall there. Yes, and so she is all are in confused state. Then Lorry comes up and he is like, now I am older and I'll tell you how to dry ourselves. Yes, so now he is just as if he is the eldest one. Now he is suggesting like, I will tell you what should be done.
How do you know you are older than me? How old are you?
Why should I tell you my age? It's rude to ask someone's age. So now there is a conversation. Let's see what is the main, how the caucus race will begin. So Mouse comes up. As you can see the picture of Mouse. Mouse says, sit down. I know how we can all be drawn. Everyone circles around the mouse and the mouse is in the middle. Mouse speaks, William the Conqueror was the first Norman King of England. Alice says,
how can William the Conqueror make me dry? He died centuries ago, and what a dry, boring story.
So Mouse gets excited and he says,
exactly, a dry story will dry us out.
So it's like everyone is in a confused state and the mouse is trying to find a way to make everyone dry. So his suggestion was to give a dry story, such a boring story. If everyone hears the dry story, everyone will become dry. So this is an imaginary part, children. This really won't happen. Let's see the next idea.
Dodo says, I know how we can get dry. We should run a caucus race. That will dry us out.
Caucus race? What is a caucus race?
Dodo, what he is doing, he is making out a circular track. Okay, he is making a track, circular track. So he explains, a caucus is a group of people. Haven't you heard of a caucus of politicians? Since our other companions like March, Hare, Hatter, Cheshire Cat are not here today, we are the caucus. This is our track. So he says, like politicians run, no, for their seat in the similar manner. Like they are a group of people running the government. So the some of the companions are not here, but the track is ready. So we are the caucus and we will be now running.
Lorry says, I can't wait to get started. Where's the starting line?
We can start from anywhere.
Not a bad idea.
You run, I fly. We all get dry.
So everyone is suggesting their own ways. So everyone chose a different places. So now Lizard is saying,
which way do we run? When does the race start?
So Lizard is in a confused state. Like every game got a rule, no? Like we have to run in this direction and this will be the starting point. This will be the ending point. There are some rules. In this direction only you have to run and all and all and all. But there was no such clarification made by Dodo, was it? No. Let's read next. So Dodo says,
stand anywhere, face any direction, run any time, just run.
So everyone faced any direction. Some are running in a clockwise, like how clocks move, no children? 1, 2, 3, like this, no? The clocks move in this direction. Some were running in this direction, some were running in alternate direction, some were running in zigzag direction. Now Lizard has one more doubt.
When do we stop? I'm running out of breath.
Dodo says, don't stop. So everyone is running, but getting slower. Now Dodo also got tired. Now he says, stop. So all of them stopped and they all crowded around Dodo. Now some are double up, they are panting, they are bumping into each other. Yes, since they were running very fast, no? So they were bending over. Yes, when you get tired, you bend over, no? So they were bending over, they were like, this is called panting. And then they were bumping, they were walking on each other, like they were walking into each other. So the mouse is asking, is the race over? Who won? So Dodo thinks with his finger in his forehead, we all won. All? How can we all win? Every race has one winner, I'm sure. I won. So Dodo says, he's going to say something. Smugly means, children, looking and sounding pleased with oneself. Like whatever he is going to say, he is very much convinced with the fact. Jo bhi hum wo bolne ja rahe, wo use puri tarah se sach manta hai. We ran this race to get dry. Are you all dry? So the main motive was what, children? Everybody got drowned and they all were wet. The main intention was to get themselves dried. So all are checking themselves after that. They all said, yes, we all are dry. Dodo says, see, everybody has won. Everybody must get a prize. So everybody has won since their main motive was to dry themselves and everybody has dried. So definitely everybody won. So Alice takes out some candies and distributes them. So Mouse says to Alice, where is your prize? Dodo says, we are all winners, so we all must get a prize. Don't you have anything else in your pocket? So what did Alice find then? Alice finds a thimble. Okay, children, a thimble is something. It's like a cap worn on the thumb. When a person is sewing, jab silai karte hain, taki us thumb ko wo जो हमारा सुई है वो चुभने से बचे, उसके लिए एक थिम्बल पहना जाता है, एक कैप की तरह होता है, वो हमारे थंब को प्रोटेक्ट करता है. सो दैट थिम्बल वॉज विद एलिस. सो डोडो टेक्स इट एंड हैंड्स इट टू हर. डोडो सेज, दिस इज फॉर यू. एलिस बोज एंड एक्सेप्ट द थिम्बल. एवरीबडी चीयर्स एंड मंचिंग कैंडी नॉइजली. सो एवरीबडी जस्ट एंजॉयड दिस पार्ट. This story was written by Lewis Carroll. Her pen name was Charles Lutwidge Godsons. He was an English mathematician and writer. Yes, he was a very good mathematician and he used to write many stories. His most popular one is Alice Adventures in Wonderland. You all might have heard about it. And its sequel, so many other parts were also there of this story. Through the Looking Glass was one of them. So this is all about the author of the story. So after finishing with that chapter explanation, we will be now discussing the question answer. So children, please take out page number 95. First, let us do the in-text question. In-text questions are the question which is given within your book. Please have a look inside the book. Why did Alice need the golden key? Yes, children. Why did she wanted the golden key? Yes, very good. Alice needed the golden key to go into the garden. Yes, when she fell down in that hallway part, she wanted to go outside and just have a look in the garden. For that, she needed the golden key. What do you think of the instruction that Dodo gives for the race? Was it an instruction? Yes, nothing was very much clear. Let's see what would be the answer. The instructions given by Dodo are not instructions at all. It's like asking everyone to run however they want. Like there was not such instruction like it is given in any games. Instead, it was like everybody has to run whatever their wish was. Do you think that every race has one winner or that everyone must get a prize? Although the right thing to do is to declare one winner. In this case, it is quite right that everyone is dry, so everyone has won. Basically, we all consider, no, every game should have a one winner. But the motive should be very clear. What was the motive of that race? Here the motive was to get dry. And since everyone got dry, so definitely everybody has won here. Yes, you can see the picture of Dodo, cartoon Dodo. This is Alice, this is the mouse. So here, page number 95, children, all of you take out your book. You will find match the following. So let's have a look at the answers. Narrator introduces the plays and the characters. Alice hands out prizes. Laurie quarrels about her age. Dodo introduces the caucus race. Mouse begins the boring tale. Canary flies during the race. And Lizard is the first one to get tired during the race. You may take the screenshot now. Now we'll move on to idioms. Yes, children, this one is very important. See, when we have a look at some words, it is giving us different meaning. Yes, and suppose we group them, but the literal meaning is different, whereas the individual meaning, we'll have a look at the idioms. Let's have a look first at the definition. An idiom is a group of words with a meaning different from the meaning of the individual word. When we considered a single words in that idiom, it will give a total different meaning. But then when we all together consider it as an idiom, the meaning is totally different. As you can see, children, an eye opener. So when I consider the words as different, eye opener, like a person who opens the eye, but that's not true. Here in an idiom, an eye opener means something that is surprising and also helps one to understand something in a new and different way, like opening a new way of thinking. That's what eye opener basically means. Put a tick here. You have to learn this one. Very important. You should know the definition first of idiom and then what all are the idioms basically and what do they generally mean. Yes, let's move on. Match the following. You can see page 97. Visiting the village hit by the storm was an eye-opener to me. So, was an eye-opener to me. Do not go away. Stay close at hand because I need your help. I enjoy visiting Sila because her parents always greet me with open arms. Look after these books and use them carefully. I had to pay through the nose to buy them for you. Pay through the nose, like very costly, too much. The race was exciting because Ronit and Reena were running neck to neck to the finishing line. So this will be the answer. I ate so many chocolates. I certainly have a sweet tooth. Sweet tooth like means a person is very fond of eating sweet things. Let's move to next page. Page 97 only, you will see there are some feelings, okay? There are some expression and the words are given in this box. So accordingly, we'll be filling it. In the first one, I have written overjoyed, but in the box, overjoyed is not given. You may write happy here. In the second one, the boy looks puzzled. Puzzled means the boy is little bit confused. In the third one, the boy is enraged, very angry. In this page, number 98, you will find the boy is little sad, he is sorrowful. Little weary, weary means tired, horrified, feared. Let's have a look to adjectives. Yes, adjectives are very important, children. What does adjective means? इट क्वालिफाइज और डिस्क्राइब्स अ नाउन. जब हम नाउन की बात करते हैं उसे जब डिस्क्राइब किया जाता है कोई वर्ड के थ्रू तो उसे एडजेक्टिव कहते हैं. देर आर थ्री फॉर्म्स ऑफ एडजेक्टिव. थ्री फॉर्म्स और थ्री डिग्रीज ऑफ एडजेक्टिव. एज यू कैन सी देर आर पॉजिटिव, कंपेरेटिव, सुपरलेटिव. पॉजिटिव जो हम लोग बेस फॉर्म हो गया ओल्ड. कंपेरेटिव जो कि अगर हम दो चीज़ों के बीच में कंपेरिजन करें, इफ़ आई एम कंपेयरिंग बिटवीन टू थिंग्स देन वी जनरली यूज कंपेरेटिव डिग्री. Superlative, when the comparison is made between more than, like among three or more than two, basically you can say, then it is said to be a superlative degree. Whenever we use a comparative degree, children, after that adjective, we generally use than, than, than. And in the superlative, children, superlative degree, you will always find that before my adjective, we generally use the. The oldest, the eldest, whatever it is. Hope it is clear. Let's move on. Let's complete the table part. Weak, weaker than the weakest. Great, greater than the greatest. Cold, colder than the coldest. Next comes some two-syllable adjectives ending with Y. Change their degrees with ER and EST, and Y is replaced by an I. Here, children, always remember, suppose there are two-syllable adjective. Two-syllable in the sense happy. So here it became two-syllable. Matlab, usse jab hum pronounce kare, to wo do bhaag mein bat jata hai. And then you will find that there is an adjective which is having Y at the end. Hamesha uske peeche agar end hai, Y hai. So what we will be doing, if we are changing the degree, we will remove Y and we will write I. H-A-P-P-I, and we will add ER if we are changing to comparative, and EST if we are changing to superlative. In the next page, you will be able to see happy, happier than the happiest. The same goes with the busy. We will remove Y and we will write I, and then simply we'll be adding ER. It becomes busier than, or it becomes the busiest. Same goes with silly, sillier than the silliest. Next, children, when a short adjective ends with a consonant sound with a vowel just before it, we double the last letter to form the comparative degree. Jab mera jo adjective hai, wo consonant sound se band ho raha. Consonant means the alphabets which are not vowels. Okay, other than vowels are said to be as consonant. B, D, these kinds of alphabets. So here you will find thin, thin, N, it is ending with N. So here N is my consonant, and before that N you find I, and I is a vowel. So when you find like these word, you simply, what you are going to do, you are going to double the N part. Like here we will be doubling N, it becomes thinner and the thinnest. Next comes big, bigger than the biggest. Hot, hotter than the hottest. Clear? Let's move on to the next one. Suppose the adjective is very longer. Okay, when it is a longer one, no, children, we do not use, or we do not add ER or EST at the end. What we are going to do? We are going to put more or most before that word. Yes, if it was helpful, it became more helpful in the comparative form, and in the superlative form, it became most helpful. Clear? Important becomes more important than the most important. Interesting become more interesting than the most interesting. But there are even some more exceptions which do not follow any of these rules. Like we all have heard about good, better, best. Same goes with the old, worse, worst. Yes, in the similar way, it is not necessary that all the adjectives are going to follow these rules. There are some exceptions. These are the exceptions. Children, please learn it. Put a tick here, write L-E-A-R and learn. So let's just move to reference to context. Take out page number 95, open your copy, write the question in a very good handwriting. This should be written in a very, very good handwriting. Write little slowly. But then the handwriting should be good one. As you can see, reference to context means a reference extract from the extract, it is given some line, and then from there some questions are asked. Let's have a look. Mouse says William the Conqueror was the first Norman king of England. So what does Mouse start telling the group? The mouse start telling the group a boring tale. What does he mean by a dry story? He means that the story is not interesting. The story is boring. Does the group like the story? What do they say? No, the group does not like the story. They ask Mouse how a boring story could make them dry. Take the screenshot. Third question, Dodo says, see, everybody has won. Everybody must get a prize. So what is going on and what has everybody won in? Yes, the answer will be a caucus race is being conducted. Everybody won the race. Bit B, how has everybody won? Why isn't there just one winner? everybody won the race because they all got dry. There isn't just one winner because they weren't competing against each other. They participated in the race to dry themselves and now everybody is dry. Question C. What prize does everybody get? Yes, in the last part I told no children, everybody got candies. And from whom they got the candy? They got the candies from Alice. And what did Alice get? Alice gets a thimble. Now we will move to this spelling part. Take out page number 900. At the topmost part you will find. Use the suitable words to form sentence in the evolving given above in the following sentences. You have to change the tense of some words. The coach advised. Please have a look at the spelling, which is very important. Advised the students to warm up before the game. But B, my father got his driving license. L-I-C-E-N-C-E. License. Number C, the prophecy that the world would end at the turn of the millennium did not come true. Prophecy. Question number D, the girl practiced a lot for the debate competition. So here we have finished up with this part. Hope you all have understood the chapter properly and enjoyed the part. Please don't forget to write this in your copy and complete the work today itself. Thank you very much for watching the video.